The Philippine Finance Chief lauds the imposition of value-added taxes on digital services. Secretary Ralph Recto says the move corrects a system that is advantageous to foreign digital service providers. He notes the law will foster fairness, competition, and inclusion in the local tax system and marketplace. Lawmaker economist Joey Salceda, meanwhile, believes the law will raise up to 12 billion pesos in its first year. The chairman of the House Ways and Means Committee says the local creative sector are the biggest winners after years of foreign creatives selling to Filipinos without any tax. Now, Fitch unit BMI expects aggressive policy easing from the Philippine Central Bank next year. The research group, in a new commentary, projects 75 more basis points in cuts this year to bring the key borrowing rate to 5.5%. That expectation followed an earlier jumbo cut by the Federal Reserve, and with local consumer prices expected to remain within target. For the Banco Central's October 17 meeting, BMI says it will have to cut by 50 bips to support economic growth. It expects further policy easing to bring the benchmark to 4.5%.
More Chinese investments coming into the Philippines despite the maritime row between the two countries. The Board of Investments said it approved over a billion pesos worth of projects from Chinese sources from January to September this year. That figure is 237% higher than the same period last year. The approvals for the first 9 months also surpassed the full-year project registration from Chinese investors at 619 million pesos. The development comes after Manila withdrew from infrastructure ties with Beijing last year, dropping a number of projects worth hundreds of billions of pesos. The Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank vows to give the Philippines access to more development grants for resilient infrastructure projects. The AIIB made the commitment during the annual meeting of its Board of Governors last month in Uzbekistan. The Philippine Finance Department said the AIIB will help Manila access grants through a multilateral financial mechanism aimed at promoting high-quality infrastructure and connectivity investments in developing countries. Government is also processing AIIB loans for other big-ticket projects. Those include the Laguna Lakeshore Road Network and the Metro Manila Rail Transit Line 4.
The Philippines welcomes India's move to lift its export ban on non-basmati white rice. The Agriculture Department expects the move to relieve price pressures in the international market. It notes 40% of rice in the international market comes from India. India banned rice exports last year amid a dip in production and the threat of the El Niño phenomenon. Upon its return to the market, it has imposed a minimum export price of $490 per metric ton.
Philippine wage boards approve a minimum wage hike in the three regions. Cagayan Valley workers can expect a 30 peso daily minimum wage increase across all sectors. The hike in Central Luzon is at 50 to 66 pesos, depending on the industry. Meanwhile, Soxergen will be increasing daily wages by 27 to 48 pesos. The wage hike follows President Marcos Jr.'s Labor Day directive to review minimum wages across the country.